Distinguished members, ladies and gentlemen, I am honored to deliver the opening remarks for the 2020 Annual General Meeting of the Indian Institute of Public Administration. I am very pleased to be here today, but before we commence the proceedings, I would like to take a few moments to remember the year that has passed and the events that unfolded. In a way, 2019-20 had been somewhat a tragic year for IIPA, as IIPA lost its widely respected and beloved chairman, Sri T.N. Chaturvedi ji, on 5th January 2020. IIPA also lost another of its stalwarts on 3rd January 2020, Dr. U.C. Agrawal, former CVC of India, who had been a long-time life member of IIPA as well as its former director. The tragic memories notwithstanding, the academic activities of the institute intensified in year 2019-20. While capacity building and study visit program became more diverse and wide-ranging in coverage, applied research work, especially in problematic areas of governance, engaged faculty and officers alike at a reasonably pressured pace. Resource mobilization was a proportionate success, helping the institute to further improve its annual accounts. At the end of financial year in March 2020, the activities of IIPA slowed down considerably due to the global pandemic of COVID-19. In capacity building, the institute got into the government's flagship schemes, public policy and governance for the lateral entrant in the position of Joint Secretary to Government of India, senior executives of forest officers and civil engineers, mid-career training program of Indian Revenue Services, custom and indirect taxes, management development program for judges and other judicial officers of Government of Uttar Pradesh, international training of probationers of Indian Revenue Service in Europe, ITech program of the MEA, leadership and team building, soft skills for public sector executives, urban governance and implementation of AMRUT related schemes, e-governance training of trainers, customized modules on change management and governance processes, climate change and smart cities, administrative laws for senior engineers, re-engineering with the Digital India framework, gender sensitivity and women empowerment leadership program for CTAs, consumer protection, new public policy, especially for scientists, provided the faculty with the new learning and teaching opportunities. In all, IIPA conducted 145 skill development programs, seminars and workshops, up 22% from the previous year. About 7,191 officers, including foreign trainees, attended and took training activities, up 47% from the previous year. The institute earned about 20.78 crores gross income, up 24% approximately. IIPA's applied research wing gained a qualitative upswing with the specific governance areas of concern. On the urban front, IIPA carried out studies on energy efficiency of eco-cities, city-level studies to assess urban governance issues, processes, innovations, and manpower requirement of NDMC. The National Consumer Helpline at IIPA expanded its consumer grievances monitoring services by integrating it with the Digital India initiative. Our faculty carried out 67 research studies for various central ministries and state government with gross receipt of rupees 4.64 crore, up by 80%. IIPA has been entrusted with the task to strengthen training and active research in various aspects of tribal welfare by Ministry of Tribal Affairs, Government of India. For this purpose, a center of excellence has been established at IIPA and is named as the Center of Tribal Research and Exploration, CORTREX. IIPA conducted special lecture series on topics of current relevance in 2019-20. And eminent speakers were invited. Lieutenant General Syed Atta Hasnain, spoken Jammu and Kashmir. Sri Anil Swaroop, IAS, retired former secretary to Government of India. Air Chief Marshal, retired B.S. Dhanova. Sri Pradeep Bajal, former chairman, TRAI. Mr. Balwinder Kumar, member, RERA UP and former secretary to Government of India, presented their valuable insights on new education policy, Indo-China relationship, India's strategic architecture, and other important topics. Faculty and training delegations made exposure visit to Netherlands, Belgium, Switzerland, France, Germany, Australia, and New Zealand. IAPA publication continued to be the highlight of IAPA. Our faculty, in addition to conducting training and research, have authored publications and seminar papers and continue to advise various ministries through lectures, presentation, and membership in policy and advisory forums of the government. 45th Advanced Professional Program in Public Administration, popularly known as APPA, commenced on 1st July 2019, which was graced by Honorable Chairman IIPA Sri T.N. Chaturvedi. The convocation at the closure of the 45th APPA was held on 30th April 2020. The convocation address was delivered online by Honorable Minister for DOPT, PMO, Atomic Energy and Space, Dr. Jitendra Singh. On knowledge dissemination front, through IIPA publications, the partnership of IIPA with SAGE has given a new visibility not only to the IJPA but to IIPA also. The Institute's main support and client base for academic activities, including the central government departments like the Department of Personnel and Training, Ministry of Urban Development, Department of Consumer Affairs, Department of Science and Technology, Ministry of Environment and Forest, Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, the Dr. Ambedkar Foundation, Ministry of Travel Affairs, as also the Honorable High Court of Allahabad and Legal Departments, Government of UP. The Institute conveys its gratitude to the DOPT and other ministries at the center and states and to all other agencies for their support for the training, research, workshops and seminars and other activities at IAPA, which assist the government effort to continuously upgrade knowledge base and improve quality of public services. We place on record our gratitude and appreciation for the constant support provided by Honorable Vice President of India and the President IAPA, the Chairman IAPA and the members of Executive Council. The Institute also thanks all the office bearers of regional and local branches of IAPA and faculty members of IAPA, officers and staff of the Institute for their sincere effort in the overall development of this great institution. We are grateful to all those within and outside IAPA who have assisted us and contributed to the success of our activities and efforts during 2019 and 2020. Jai Hind!